Hello, and welcome to the 7th episode of CCR Liberty in Detail. In our previous episode, we were looking at the scrubbers, what they do and what options we have and how to pack one. And in this episode, we're going to be having a look at our wings, at our backplates and the stands, and the things that are associated with it. So let's dive into it. The first thing that we're going to have a look at today will be our wings. All the wings that we're going to be having a look at have a 22 liters or 48 pounds of lifting capacity. The reason behind this capacity is that the wing needs to provide you a sufficient lift in the case of a complete flooding of the system. So the choice of the wing is entirely up to you and is based on your personal preference. What you can choose from is either a horseshoe shape wing, or you can pick a horseshoe shape with bungees, or you can go for a donut shape. And now we're going to have a look at those in a little bit more detail. So now we're going to have a look at the horseshoe shape wings. They're both made out of Cordura 1000 material, which provides enough durability. The advantage of the horseshoe shape wing is that you can actually separate the lift and it would compensate on an extra weight that you would be carrying on one side. So the second choice for the horseshoe wing is a horseshoe wing with bungees. This wing actually has elastic bungee cords on the sides where you can adjust the tension on the bungees, and the bungees actually help to deflate the wing and pull the wing down to reduce any dead spaces within the wing, and also help it to keep a smaller shape as it can have. The next option that you can go for is a horseshoe shaped wing. This one's made out of twill, and it comes either in red or a black color. The difference between this and the other wings is that you can dump gas out of this wing from any position. The other feature of this wing is that because the bottom part of it is inflated as well, it could help you with holding the trim in the water in the case that you like wearing heavier fins. Because this bottom part is inflated as well, the overall size of the wing is actually smaller than the horseshoe shaped wing while maintaining the same volume of the wing. The choice of a wing is a very subjective thing, and at the end of the day, it all comes down to your own personal preference. When it comes down to Liberty Light, the Liberty Light itself actually comes with a donut wing as well, same as with the donut wing for the back mounted units. You can select whether you would like it to come in a red color or in a black color. Now we're going to have a look at the options that you can choose from when it comes down to backplates. Liberty has its own type of backplate that is specifically designed for the unit based on our philosophy. The standard backplate can either come in stainless steel or it can come in titanium. As you can see, it looks very similar. However though, the titanium version gives you about 2.2 kilos saving in weight. The backplates can be also fitted with additional D-rings that you can select in our configurator. This is what they look like. And this is where you can place them. So you can basically put them anywhere along the sides of your backplate. As we have demonstrated in our episode number 2, in the middle of our backplate, you can see the locking mechanism. The locking mechanism is based on our philosophy of you not being able to detach your head and the scrubber during the dive. And for the safety purposes, you need to get the unit off your back then pull this lock lever open, and that will allow you to detach the head with your scrubber canister. So this locking mechanism is a part of all the back mounted units apart from the Liberty light. So I'm going to show you how we figured the locking system out with the Liberty light. I've got the Liberty light here. And as you can see, Liberty light is a soft pack. So we have a soft pack with a weight harness in here, but to make it as light as possible, there are no metal parts. The harness is actually held by carbon fiber plates, but we're going to have a look at those later down the video when we're going to be talking about the harnesses. So what we did here is that we came up with a special lock. So this lock substitutes the function of this lock and keeps the scrubber and the head nicely close together. So every light unit comes with a new lock. The lock is easily placed into the locking system. Then you push those levers down, which will secure the lock in its place. And you line up the teeth with the head and close the lock down, and this holds the system together. The way to open it is you pull on the levers, open the lock up. The advantage of the lock is that when you push it upward, it actually splits the head and the scrubber open. So it makes it nice and easy to separate these two. So now we're going to have a look at the first stage regulators attachment, where they are. So on a back mounted unit, the first stage regulators, we use Apex DST, and they are attached to the back plate. The reason why they are attached to the back plate is because we wanted to save on mounting points. So the first stages are attached to the back plate, which creates a mounting point for us. And the cylinder is screwed first into the first stage regulator, and then it's just pulled down by this band, and the cylinder is attached to our unit, and it creates one complete system. When it comes to Liberty light, the Liberty light comes with Apex flight regulators, and the reason for that is simply because we were trying to reduce the weight everywhere where we could. This is the same case for the side mount unit, which comes with Apex flight regulators as well. Speaking of reducing the weight, we did our best to reduce the weight of the Liberty light as much as we can, and what we achieved is 15.3 kilos without cylinders, which makes it nice and easy to travel with while maintaining the unit's durability, and at the same time providing you with enough weight space for you to be able to fit the unit with enough weight, even if you do cold water dry suit diving. Now we're going to have a look at the options for the stands. We have two main types of stands that you can choose from. We have a standard stand, which is smaller and a lighter, and we have a long and wide stand, which gives you more of a lumbar support, and it also makes the unit a lot more stable when being placed on a ground or on a boat or anywhere. You can see the standard stand here, and you can see the long and the wide stand here. Both those types of stands come either in stainless steel or in titanium. When it comes to titanium, the weight saving on the stand is about 0.8 kilos. The other advantage of the long and a wide stand is that you can attach additional D-rings to it. So then they can be, for example, placed here, or they can be placed into the lower position based on your preference. If you decide to go with a complete titanium option, your weight saving is about 3 kilos. When it comes to side mount configuration, all the units come with a titanium frame to save weight of the unit. I've actually got another one here that's fitted with all the strips. It actually has handles on it for easier handling of the unit. The Liberty Light unit also comes with an optional stand, which can be selected in our configurator if you wish to have your unit more stable, either on the ground or for any assembly. There is no problem to add the stand to it. In a back-mounted counterlung configuration, the counterlungs on top are attached with a quick-release buckle, as well as on a front-mounted counterlungs. And they are also attached by a zipper that is here going along the side. The zipper down here is secured with a Velcro for just to make sure that it doesn't unzip itself. So to take it off, you just open the Velcro up, unzip it, and then you can just take the counterlung off. Some people choose, including me, not using the quick disconnect buckle, but just use the Velcro that's up in the top part of the counterlung. And I personally find this easier, but this again comes down to a personal preference. On Liberty Light, the counterlungs are attached the same way with the zipper, but the way they are secured here is by this elastic band that it's held on a screw and that keeps the zipper from not undoing itself on its own. So to undo the zipper, you just simply pull the bungee up, pull it up, and you take the counterlung off. While we're detaching our counterlungs, we can actually see our overpressure valves. So on a back-mounted counterlungs, it's located here, and there is a pulley up on the top here, so it sits nicely up here on your shoulder, easier to find and grab. On the front-mounted counterlungs, the overpressure valve is here. You can actually adjust the tension when you want the overpressure valve to open. The way to detach the front-mounted counterlungs is very similar. You have a quick-release buckle up here. Simply pull up and it will clip open. And we have a Velcro here that holds onto your harness webbing. And you open that up and you take the counterlung off. Both the counterlungs, the front-mounted counterlungs and back-mounted counterlungs have 3.5 liters of volume, so 7 liters of the volume in total. When it comes to Liberty's side mount unit, we have two counterlungs as well. They're actually inside here of this casing, and we are looking at a total volume of 6 liters. The way these counterlungs are attached to the frame is by using these hooks. So the hooks are attached and hooked to the frame, just simply hooking onto the frame, easily like that. And they are held up by the cylinders, by the two cylinders that are stored underneath it, and give the lungs a bit of a tension so they are nicely held in a place and keeping them from detaching themselves. The last thing that we're going to talk about today is the harness. The Liberty uses the standard harness, which is threaded through the back plate in a very, very similar way to what you would find in your open circuit back plate. But you can choose if you would like to have a quick release buckle as a part of your system. You can choose if you would like to have just one on either side, or if you would like to have two in case you need to often get your unit of yourself in the water to get on a boat or for any other reason, you can choose this in our configurator while you're configuring your unit. You can actually see this unit has the quick release buckle as a part of the webbing already. They are very durable. So, and the other great thing about those buckles is that if you accidentally pull on one of the levers, it would not open the lock up. You really do have to pull both of them at the same time in order to be able to open the buckle up. Okay, so that's it for our episode. I hope that you found this episode informative and it helped you with a configuration that would be right for you to choose. And as always, if you would like to find more information, please visit our webpage at divesoft.com, where you can find our configurator, where you can have a play and configure the unit based on your desired configuration, or you can email us at info@divesoft.com to get any further information. Thank you for
Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.
No, I will see you next time.